So in this session we will continue with question number 12. Use graph paper for this question. Plot the points P3, 2 and Q minus 3, minus 2. From P and Q draw perpendiculars PM and QM on the x axis. First we will do this part. So 12th one. Take graph sheet. Mark the points. Scale you can take 1 centimeter. Approach I'll write the scale. Okay. It is there, approach I'll write. How many will take 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit? Okay. Now, here they are asking us to plot the points P3, 2. Next, Q minus 3, minus 2. Both are minus. Minus 3, minus 2 means this is third quadrant. So it will come here. This is Q. Minus 3, minus 2. Correct? From P and Q, draw perpendiculars PM and QN. Draw perpendiculars PM and QN. So PM and QN. So this is N. Or this is Q. This is N. This is P. This is M. This is perpendicular angle. So on the x axis, first point, first question. Name the image of P on the reflection in the origin. So P we have to reflect in the origin. So what we will get if you reflect in the origin? So origin means reflection in the origin is x, y is equal to minus x minus y, isn't it? Minus x minus y. So therefore, what it will happen? So same, you will get the. So therefore, reflection in the origin, P on reflection in origin, we get P dash, Q minus 3 minus 2. Next, second point. Assign the special name to the geometrical figure PMQN. PMQN. So we have to join this. PMQN. So what is the geometrical name for PMQN? So geometrical name. Geometrical name of figure PMQN is what we can say. Parallelogram. So what is the area? So area is equal to base into height. If you observe, this is the height, 2 centimeters. So what is the base? Base is we can say from here to here, 3 and 3, 6, 6 and 2, 6 to 12, so base is equal to 6 into height is equal to 12 units, square units, correct, 12 square units, that is the answer, second answer. Write the coordinates of the point to which M is mapped on deflection, M is mapped on reflection on x-axis. So M is what coordinates here? 3 comma 0. So M 3 comma 0 on reflection. Third answer I am writing. On x-axis, what happens? M dash. What you get? Reflection on x-axis. X minus y. That is same invariant. This is similarly M on reflection on y-axis. M dash, double dash we can say, reflection on y axis, so what happens, minus 3 comma 0, similarly, reflection on origin, M on reflection on origin, is equal to M triple dash, origin means minus 3, 0, correct, so these are the points, M reflection on x axis, y axis and origin. So this is, so I understood the geometrical name of the figure PMQN is, it is nothing but a parallelogram. Area means base into height, base means how we can find out 1, 2, 3 plus 3 units, 6 units into height is 2 units, 6 to ja, 12 square units. Note down this sum. So we move on to the next question. That is 13th question. The point P 3 comma 4 is reflected to P dash in the x axis and O dash is the image of O origin and reflected in the line PP dash using graph sheet, graph paper. Give the coordinates of P dash and Q dash, O dash. Okay, so point is given. So use graph paper, they are saying. Use graph paper. X dash O X. Y O Y dash. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I am not writing the scale. So understood, I am taking 1 cm is equal to 1 unit. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7. Okay. So what they are asking first? The point P is reflected to P dash in x axis. And O dash is the image of O origin when reflected in the line P. Okay. O dash is the image of is reflected in the line PP dash. Okay. Now P, how much? 3 comma 4. X value 3, Y value 4. This is P. When it is reflected in x-axis, they are same, reflected in x-axis. So what is reflection? 3 comma minus 4. X value 3, y value minus 4. So this is P dash. Okay? 3 comma minus 4. 3 comma minus 4. Okay. So what is the coordinates of P dash? 3 comma minus 4. Now join this. So this is the line. PP dash is the line. Now what they are saying? Now O dash is the image of origin when reflected in the line PP dash. So O origin is 0, 0 here. Isn't it? And it is reflecting on the line PP dash. So what is the meaning of that? How to write the image of O? That is the question. You have to count here. 1, 2, 3. So he told already, image means it is nothing but the same distance as of the object from the mirror. Now this PP dash is the mirror line. Okay. So this is the object. Its image is formed here behind the line PP dash. So therefore, how much distance is there, this origin from the line, the same distance will be from the line to the image. Isn't it? So 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. So this is O dash. So 6 comma 0. So that is the image line. Understood? You can note down in the textbook also. Second question, first question, the coordinates of P dash and the O dash. P dash is 3 comma minus 4. O dash is 6 comma 0. Understood? Next, the length of the segments PP dash and O dash. The length of the segments, that is PP dash how much? Here 4. Here 4, totally 6. So length of the segment PP dash is equal to 6 units. Second answer I am writing. So what is the length of the O dash? That is also 3 plus 3, 6 units. Sorry, this is 4 plus 4, 8 units. This is 8 units. And O dash is here 3, here 3. Totally 6 units. Okay? Next, the geometrical name of the figure P O P dash O dash P O P dash and O dash. So we have to join all this. Okay, that is given in the textbook also. The figure is given in the textbook. So what is the geometrical name? Equal size, isn't it? So therefore, it is nothing but wrong. So it is nothing but a rhombus. How can we say that it is a rhombus? One thing, the side should be equal. Okay, side should be equal, and diagonal should not be equal. So if you see the diagonal over dash, it is 6 units, and diagonal, if you take a PP dash, it is 8 units. So therefore, diagonals are not equal. Therefore, it is a rhombus. By that we can say it is a rhombus. Okay. Diagonals are not equal also. They are bisect each other at right angles, because it is 90 degrees. So therefore, we can say it is a rhombus. Now fourth sum I will do here. Fourth sum. The perimeter of the quadrilateral POP O dash. The perimeter of the quadrilateral we have to find out, isn't it? So perimeter means we want to find out what. So if you take this is a right angle, I have to find out the hypotenuse first. That is O dash P. Okay? So O dash P is nothing but, we can say one more name we can give here. This is M, I can give the name. So according to Pythagoras theorem, O dash P or OP square is equal to OM square plus PM square. So first I will find out what is OP. OP square by Pythagoras theorem. By Pythagoras theorem. OP square is equal to OM square plus PM square. We don't know OP square. We can don't know the length of OP. Using Pythagoras theorem only we can find out, isn't it? So that is, what is OM? OM is 3 units, 3 square. Plus, what is PM? PM is 4 units, 4 square. That is 9 plus 16, that is equal to 25. Therefore, OP is equal to root 25. That is equal to 5 units. So, 5 units. Similarly, if you take this also. This is 3, this is 4. It is also 5 units. It is also 5 units. It is also 5 units. Because it is a rhombus. So, therefore, perimeter is equal to perimeter of the given figure. I can write from the textbook also. What is the figure? POP-O' is equal to all the sides. We have to add OP plus OP dash plus O dash P dash plus O dash P. O dash P. So 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5. That is equal to 20 units. 20 units. Therefore, perimeter of this given figure rhombus is how much? 20 units. So only one hypotenuse you have to find out. That is one side of OP you have to find out. Because all they have in same units. If you take this triangle also you will get OP dash is 5 units. If you take this right angle triangle also you will get O dash P dash are 5 units. If you take the triangle PMO dash also you will get the hypotenuse 5 units. So therefore the length of all the sides, sum of the length of all the sides of a rhombus is 4 into A. That is nothing but 4 5s are 20 units. Or you can add 5 plus 5 plus 5 plus 5. That is equal to 20 units. So note down this sum. So I want to give 14th sum as homework sum for you. 14th sum as homework sum. Do it in a home using graph paper. Okay? Using graph paper. Now I'll move on to the next question. The question number is 15. The question number is 15. So what is the question says? In a triangle ABC with vertices A1, 2, B4, 4 and C3, 7 is first reflected in the line Y is equal to 0 onto triangle A dash, B dash, C dash. And then triangle A dash, B dash, C dash is reflected in the origin to find out A double dash, B double dash, C double dash. Write down the coordinates of A dash, B dash, C dash. Write the coordinates of A double dash, B double dash, C double dash. Write down the single transformation that maps triangle ABC directly onto the A double dash, B double dash and C double dash. Now we will see. Okay. First, take the graph sheet. Draw the coordinate axis. Draw the coordinate axis. Coordinate axis. Coordinate axis. Same scale. I am taking 1 cm equal to 1 unit. Or if you want, you can take 2 cm equal to 2 units in your graph sheet. Okay. In examination, you get the 2 cm graph sheet, 2 cm equal to 1 unit, So now graph is ready. So now I want to plot A1, 2. A 1, x value 1, y value 2. This is A. 1, 2. Next, B 4, 4. X value 4, y value also 4. B 4, 4. Next, C 3, 7. X value 3, y value 7. So here, C 3, 7. Okay. Now I'll join A, B, C. It is a triangle, isn't it? A, B, C is a triangle. Next, I want to reflect in the line Y is equal to 0. So I want to equate in the line Y is equal to 0 means what this one in here, it is nothing but X axis. Y is equal to 0 means it is nothing but X axis, equation of line X is equal to X axis, correct? So now I want to reflect on X axis. So A 1, 2 means what happens here? 1, 2. X value 1, Y value -2. This is A 1, -2. B what happens? 4, -4. X value 4, Y value -4. This is B. Next C. What happens? C. C value is 3, -7. X value 3. Y value -7. Here it is. C 3, -7. Join. I will write A value here. A 1, -2. So A B, B C, and A C. Correct. So this is A dash, B dash, C dash. So they are all telling us write down the coordinates. That means what you should do. We should write down the coordinates. A dash how much you got? 1, -2. B dash how much you got? 4, -4. C dash how much you got? 3, -7. You have to write down. Don't forget it. Correct? Next. Next they are saying A dash, B dash, C dash. And then A dash, B dash, C dash is reflected in the origin. So these coordinates should be reflected in the origin. So if you reflect it in the origin, so this is the case. So what happens now? A dash if reflected in the origin. So -1, already it is minus, is there 2. -1, 2. X value -1. Okay. Y value 2. It is A double dash, this is -1, 2. Next, B 4, -4, 4. Is it? Because already minus is there. So minus of minus plus it becomes. So 4, -4, 4. X value -4, Y value 4. So it becomes here. This is B double dash, -4, 4. Next C, -3, 7. X value -3, Y value 7. So this is C double dash is all. -3, 7. Join. Join now. So I write this coordinates here so that you will not get the confusion. B double dash is what happens? -4, 4. -4, 4. So now I will join. So first I reflected in the y is equal to 0, that is nothing but x axis. Then I reflected in the origin. So that's it. So you have to write the coordinates. A double dash, how much you got? -1, 2. B double dash, how much you got? -4, 4. C double dash, how much you got? -3, 7. So you have to write the coordinates. Write on the single transformation ABC directly to A dash, B dash, C dash. So ABC was there directly to A dash, B dash, it is reflected on what? y axis. So single transformation. Second, single transformation. Single transformation from triangle ABC to triangle A double dash B double dash C double dash is y axis. That means directly we can say ABC is reflected on y axis, then you will get A double dash B double dash C double dash triangle. Correct? So that is the answer. So note down this sum. Okay, now we move on to the next question. Question number 16. Question number 16. And the last question for this today's session. For this session, not today's session, this session. Okay. Okay. 16. Use graph paper for this question. They are asking points A to B and C are the vertices of a triangle ABC. Write down the coordinates of A dash, B dash, C dash. If A dash, B dash, C dash is the image of triangle ABC reflected in the origin. Okay, first you have to take the graph sheet. Take the graph sheet. Take the graph sheet. This is x dash O x y O y dash. Mark the points first A, B, C. A 2 comma 3 they are saying. X value 2, Y value 3. A 2 comma 3. B 4, 5. X value 4, Y value 5. Here. B 4 comma 5. C 2, 7 comma 2. X value 7, Y value 2. Here. C 7 comma 2. So now join this. This is one triangle we got. Correct? Now we have to reflect this to get A dash, B dash, C dash triangle on origin. We have to reflect in origin. 2, 3 means x value 2, y value 3 means x minus 2 minus 3. Correct? Minus 2 minus 3. This is A dash. Minus 2 minus 3. B 4 comma 5 means minus 4 minus 5. Minus 4 x value minus 4, y value minus 5. Here. 1 minute. 2 comma 3. Sorry. This is x value minus 2, y value minus 3. Here it will come. Okay. A dash minus 2 minus 3. Next B minus x value minus 4, y value minus 5. Here it will come. B. So B is minus 4 minus 5. C minus 7. X value minus 7. Minus 7 minus 2. Minus 7. X value minus 7 minus 2. C minus 7 minus 2. Both are minus. So join now. I will write this B here. B is minus 4 minus 5. Now join these points. Okay? Correct. Understood now? Now next what they say, write on the coordinates of A double dash, B double dash, C double dash. If A double dash, B double dash, C double dash is the image of triangle ABC, when it is reflected in the x-axis. reflected in the x-axis, reflected in the x-axis. So 2 comma 3 means reflection in the x-axis 2 minus 3, x value 2, y value minus 3, this is a double dash, 2 minus 3, next b, 4 comma minus 5, x value 4, y value minus 5, b, 4 comma minus 5, c, 7 comma minus 2, c double dash 7 comma minus 2, join up. Okay, so this is reflection in the x-axis. Mention the special name of the quadrilateral b, c, c dash, b, c, c dash, b, c, c dash. Okay, c dash and b double dash. B double dash. So that means we have to join this. B, C, C double dash, B double dash. That means it is nothing but what? Trifusium. So what is the special name? We can write trifusium. Correct? B, C, C, C double dash. And BV double dash, they are parallels. So one pair of parallel sides and two pair of non-parallel sides are there. Therefore, it is nothing but a trifusium. So okay, I will write this answer for this question here. Third, so B. What is the name there given? B, C, C double dash, B double dash is a trifusium. Because one pair of parallel side is there, because CC double dash is parallel to BB double dash. Correct? So what is the formula to find the area of trifusium? Half into sum of the parallel sides into height, isn't it? Half into sum of the parallel sides into height. So A into, so A is equal to half into sum of parallel sides into sum of parallel sides into distance between them. Distance between them. Correct? Okay. Half into sum of parallel sides. What are parallel sides? This is C, C double double dash, B, B double dash. So it is how much? So 2, here also 2. 4 plus, this is how much? 5, 10. Into, what is the distance between them? 1, 2, 3. 3 units. So half into 14 into 3. 2 ones, 2 sevens. 21 square units. 21 square units. Correct? So how I got this? Sum of the parallel sides means first parallel side is C, C double dash. This is how much? 2 units. This is how much? 2 units. Total 4 units. Next parallel side is B, B double dash. This is how much? 5 units. This is how much? 5 units. Totally how many units? 10 units. Correct? 4 plus 10, 14. Into height, distance between the two parallel sides. 1 unit, second 2 units, 3 units. So, into 3. So, 2 ones, 2 7. 7 3 ja, 21 square units. This is the answer for question number 16. 17th question, I am giving as homework. You do it in home and show me when the school reopens. Okay, by this I will end the session. Thank you.